Zamper this morning, you know what?
Well, good morning. Welcome to our first outdoor worship service for 2022. Great to have you with us. Let's see what we've got. First of all, I welcome those of you who are joining us online. Good to have you with us. Wish you could be here. I invite you to send the blue friendship books down, put your name, information there, and then send them back to the center if you would. And then a big happy Father's Day to all of you fathers. Raise your hand if you're a father.
Yay!
So just to know, when people root, they root for you. You don't root for yourself.
Always,
always. Jacob, I bet you have a few announcements.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So if we turn like this, we're not trying to ignore you, we're just trying to block the wind out. So just for the future reference. It's good to see all of you. Happy Father's Day again. As many of you may know, I was a bit under the weather for the past couple weeks. Thank you so much for your prayers. Thank you so much for the nice messages and the beautiful phone calls. I appreciate all of you. As some of you may know, last week was a pretty big week for us. It was our VBS week. And so we have what's called day camp and night camp. Day camp happened Monday through Friday, and then night camp was Sunday evening through Wednesday. And it was where we got to come together, we got to do some pretty awesome and well-designed crafts. We got to eat some great food that was done by our snack coordinators, and the students got to hear about Jesus. And so it was a lot of fun, it was a great time. And so we'll be putting some pictures on our website here in a little bit so you can get on and kind of look at all the shenanigans that went on. And then during the children's message today, when I invite the children to come down, Pastor Ken is going to lead us in one of our favorite VBS songs so you get just a taste of what last week looked like as well. If you have any questions, I know that summer schedule is a little bit funky. If you have any questions in regards to youth, family, or education, you can also see me after service. My name is Jacob. Thanks.
Thank you, Jacob.
There we are. Thank you, Jacob. Anyone, I'm looking at the yellow announcement insert. Anyone interested in joining Jesus on his mission, talking about that, how do we live our lives and share a little hope, a little encouragement in Jesus' name with others, please meet with Steve Lord and I. Where is Steve? There's Steve right here. Directly after the worship service. And we'd like to discuss the whens and the whats. We have been having a class on Sunday morning, and we very well may do that right after. But we would like to meet not only with those who have been meeting with us, but those who might be interested to do so. That'll be right after the worship service. Denise DuBois died this Tuesday waiting for a liver transplant for the last 8 months. Denise is the daughter of Dwayne and Kathy Steinke, and she is the wife of Michael DuBois. And so I ask that you would keep them in your prayers this week and the next as they go through this difficult time of grief. Speaking of grief and other difficult things, our men's support group will be meeting this Thursday evening, 6:30. Please notice details in your bulletin. And then last week, you heard about the departure of Pastor John Graham. There have been many questions. This Wednesday evening, the council will hold an information session in the fellowship hall, 7 p.m. That's this Wednesday, June 22nd, 7 p.m., in the fellowship hall. And so we encourage you to attend. Those are the announcements. I invite you to turn to the front of your black binders. There is a booklet, it's a white in color, called Setting 4. Please turn to page 3. Please stand. We worship in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and magnify your holy name through Jesus Christ, our Lord. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Most merciful God, we confess that we are in bondage to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake forgives us all our sins. To those who believe in Jesus Christ, he gives the power to become the children of God and bestows on them the Holy Spirit. Amen.
My heart forever is wandering.
Please turn to the front part of those setting four booklets, page 3. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. Amen. The prayer of the day is printed in your bulletin. Let us pray. Lord God of all nations, you have revealed your will to your people and promised your help to us all. Help us to hear and to do what you command, that the darkness may be overcome by the power of your light through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. I invite the children to come forward. We're going to sing for you two of the favorites. One is called The Fruits of the Spirit, and the other will be our prayer, and that will be Sanctuary.
Face all the people. Face all the people. Alright, Ryan and Jason are going to lead you through the hand motion.
Well, the fruits of the Spirit, not a
coconut.
Coconut.
The fruits of the Spirit, not a
coconut.
I'm sorry, what word did you say? Say it louder.
Coconut.
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you.
Coconut.
Coconut. Let's try it again. Well, the fruits of the Spirit's not a
coconut.
The fruits of the Spirit's not a
coconut.
If you want to be a fruit, you might as well hear it for the fruits of the... For the what?
The fruits of the Spirit are...
For the fruits of the Spirit are love, joy, peace, and patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, and patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. What's another one? The fruits of the Spirit are not a what?
Abigail?
Banana.
Fruits of the Spirit are not a banana.
All right, so when we do banana, we go like this. Alright, remember? Alright, let's try it.
Well, the fruits of the Spirit's not a
banana.
The fruits of the Spirit's not a
banana.
If you want to be a
banana,
you might as well hear it as a fruit. For the fruits of love, joy, peace, and patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, and patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. One more. The fruits of the Spirit, not a...
Banana.
Yeah, we just did banana. You want to do grape? Grape's kind of fun.
Pumpkin.
Oh, a pumpkin?
You want to do pumpkin?
Right. Well, the fruits of the Spirit, not a...
Pumpkin.
The fruits of the Spirit, not a...
Pumpkin.
If you want to be a fruit, you might as well hear it, cause you can't be a fruit of the Spirit, cause the fruits are love, joy, peace, and patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, and patience,
kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. That's love, joy, peace, and patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Let's pray, and let's use one of the songs that we did, step by step. Oh God, you are my God. Page 70, I will ever praise you. Oh God, you are my God. I will ever praise you. I will seek you in the morning, and I will learn to walk in your ways, and step by step. Believe me, and I will follow you all of my days. Congregation, join us. Oh God, you are my God, and I will ever praise you. Oh God, you are my God, and I will ever praise you. I will seek you in the morning, and I will learn to walk in your ways. And step by step, you'll lead me, and I will follow you all of my day. And step by step, you'll lead me, and I will follow you all of my day.
Verses 1 through 9. I was ready to be sought out by those who did not ask, to be found by those who did not seek. I said, here I am, here I am, to a nation that did not call on my name. I held out my hands all day long to a rebellious people, walk in a way that is not good, following their own devices. A people who provoke me to my face continually, sacrificing in gardens and offering incense on bricks, who sit inside tombs and spend the night in secret places, who eat swine's flesh with broth of abominable things in their vessels, who say, keep to yourself, do not come near me, for I am too holy for you. These are smoke in my nostrils, a fire that burns all day long. See, it is written before me, I will not keep silent, but I will repay. I will indeed repay into their laps their iniquities and their ancestors' iniquities together, says the Lord. Because they offered incense on the mountains and reviled me on the hills, I will measure into their laps full payment for their actions. Thus says the Lord, as the wine is found in the cluster, and they say, do not destroy it, for there is a blessing in it. So I will do for my servant's sake, and not destroy them all. I will bring forth descendants from Jacob, and from Judah, inheritors of my mountains. My chosen shall inherit it, and my servants shall settle there. The second lesson is from Galatians 3. Now, before faith came, we were imprisoned and guarded under the law until faith would be revealed. Therefore, the law was our disciplinarian until Christ came, so that we might be justified by faith. But now that faith has come, we are no longer subject to a disciplinarian. For in Christ, you are all children of God through faith. As many of you as were baptized into Christ have clothed yourself with Christ. There is no longer Jew or Greek. There is no longer slave or free. There is no longer male and female. For all of you are one in Christ Jesus. And if you belong to Christ, then you are Abraham's offspring, heirs according to the promise.
At the country of the Gerasenes, which is opposite Galilee. As Jesus stepped out on land, a man of the city who had demons met him. For a long time he had worn no clothes, and he did not live in a house, but in the tomb. When he saw Jesus, he fell down before him and shouted at the top of his voice, "What have you to do with me, Jesus, Son of the Most High God? I beg you, do not torment me." For Jesus had commanded the unclean spirit to come out of the man. For many times it had seized him. He was kept under guard and bound with chains and shackles. But he would break the bonds and be driven by the demon into the wild. Jesus then asked him, "What is your name?" He said, "Legion." For many demons had entered him. They begged him not to order them to go back into the abyss. Now there on the hillside was a large herd of swine feeding, and the demons begged Jesus to let them enter these. So he gave them permission. Then the demons came out of the man and entered the swine, and the herd rushed down the steep bank into the lake and was drowned. When the swineherd saw what had happened, they ran off and told it in the city and in the country. Then people came out to see what had happened, and when they came to Jesus, they found the man from whom the demons had gone, sitting at the feet of Jesus, clothed and in his right mind. And they were afraid. Those who had seen it told them how the one who had been possessed by demons had been healed. Then all the people of the surrounding country of the Gerasenes asked Jesus to leave them, for they were seized with great fear. So he got into the boat to return. The man from whom the demons had gone begged that he might be with him. But Jesus sent him away, saying, "Return to your home and declare how much God has done for you." So he went away, proclaiming throughout the city how much Jesus had done for him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please be seated. We apologize for the extra sound with the wind. We're trying to control that. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. Rescued and restored. It's a story about the man that we have just heard. It's also a story about you and me. So first of all, we hear of this man of the city. It sounds pretty classy, doesn't it? A man of the city. Well respected, well dressed, walking downtown in his fine clothes with his good job, confident, self-assured. Can you picture it? He's a husband. He's a father. He's got a good job and he's going home to his comfortable house. And if we follow him as we enter that house and look through the window, we will see him and his wife and children sitting at table, and all is well. And for this man, it might have been true at one time, but it is no longer. Now he's a different man. He doesn't live in a house. Where does he live? In the tombs. He doesn't live with family. He's all alone in the wilderness. He doesn't have fine clothes. They've been long gone. And rather than getting friendly greetings from passersby, well, this man is now chained and shackled. Why? Because he's a wild man. Many times he has been placed under guard. He's dangerous. Many times he's been chained and shackled. Many times he broke those chains and was driven into the wilderness. He is dangerous. He's a threat. People are frightened. And there is no, this one is no respectable man of the city. Rather, he's simply a wild man. And what has happened? How has he become this? It seems that a demon has possessed him and driven him into the wild. And now, according to Mark's gospel, he is howling day and night among the tombs and taking stones and bruising himself with them. He is a tragic sight, driven into the wilderness by the enemy, whom Jesus calls the thief. Jesus says the thief comes only to destroy, to steal and kill, to steal our freedom, to destroy our hope, to kill our joy. We see it in spades in this man of the city. Once respectable, well-dressed, his life as a husband and father, now simply an empty shell, a shadow of what he had been, a wild man, at least until Jesus, at least until the man sees Jesus. He sees Jesus coming ashore with his disciples, and this wild man runs to Jesus and throws himself at Jesus' feet. He has a confusion of awe and fear. His awe verges on worship. What have you to do with me, Jesus of Nazareth? Jesus, Son of the Most High God. There he is, kneeling in front of him with this confession of who Jesus is. It looks like worship. And yet, even though he knows who Jesus is, this is not praise and gratitude. Rather, it's simply fear. Fear of what Jesus may do to him. Remember what he says? I beg you, do not torment me. It's all he knows, torment. It's all he has seen, chains, confusion, darkness, despair. And he assumes that Jesus will simply give him more. I beg you, do not torment me, Jesus. Would Jesus ever torment? Of course not. Jesus comes not to subject him, but rather to save him, to rescue him. Jesus asks a simple question to the man. What is your name? Who are you? What do you like? He is interested in this wild man. And the answer from the wild man is simply, legion, for we are many. The man has lost his home, his family, and now he has lost his identity. He doesn't even speak for himself. Legion, for the demons that inhabit him are many. He doesn't even remember his name. But Jesus has come to rescue him. He orders the demons, get out. The demons say, don't send us back into the abyss. How about into those swine? Jesus gives them permission. And the demons come out of the man into the swine, and the whole herd runs headlong down the steep bank into the lake and are drowned. So much for the demons. And the herders now are amazed and rush the other way to tell everyone they can find what had happened. And soon everyone gathers. And what is it that they see? Well, they see Jesus. But then this wild man sitting with Jesus. This wild man who everyone's afraid of. And the surprise is that he is sitting. Not running, crazy, but he is sitting peaceably at Jesus' feet, clothed and in his right mind. No longer wild, no longer howling, beating himself with stones, but sitting peacefully at Jesus' feet. This wild man has been rescued from the darkness. And as the people see it, they are afraid. Why? They must be asking, what kind of power can do this amazing thing? And afraid of Jesus, they ask him to leave. And as the man is leaving, the former wild man now follows him to the boat. And he begs that he might be with him, that he might stay with Jesus, go with him, follow him, this one who has rescued him from the power of darkness. Now, wouldn't you think Jesus says yes? But he says no. He refuses. He sends him away. Why? Doesn't want him? Doesn't care? Does that sound like Jesus? No. No, now that Jesus has rescued the wild man, he wants to restore him. He's rescued him from the darkness. Now he would restore him to his own life. Jesus says two things to him. Return and tell. Return to your home, Jesus says. Good news is that he still has a home. He still has a family. A wife, kids, friends, neighbors who are still there for him, and they still care. Return to your home. Be restored to those who love you. Let them get to know who you are. Return, says Jesus. Be restored. Secondly, Jesus says something else. Return to your home and declare. Tell them. Tell them your story. Tell them what God has done for you. Tell them. And the man who has so many times been chained and shackled, so many times has been under guard, so many times has broken the chains apart and been driven into the wilderness all alone, bruising himself, now rescued and in his right mind, goes and tells everyone not what God has done for him, but he's more specific. Did you catch it? He goes and declares to everyone what Jesus has done for him. And anyone hear the story is going to wonder, so this Jesus is God. What is your story? How is it that Jesus has helped you through your need? How did he heal you, restore you? How did he restore your health, your hope? How did he walk with you through the dark and dangerous times? How is it that the Lord made you his own and gave you back your name, your identity? What's your story? Jesus says, tell your story, that others may know me. Amen. Creed, we confess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord.
He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, there are so many ways that our enemy can take life and hope away from us. Like the man out in the wilderness, the wild man, fear, despair, sheer craziness. And yet you came to rescue and restore him. It might be depression or anxiety. It might be financial distress or conflicts. It may be simple confusion or simply not knowing what direction to turn. The darkness comes in many forms. And yet you, Lord, come to bring your light, to shine upon us, to give healing and hope. Lord, help us to be open to you in our grief, in our hurt. Let us turn to you for your strength and healing. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for Dwayne and Kathy, for Michael and all their families as they grieve the death of Denise. Surround them with your care. Continue to walk with them every step of this road that lies ahead. Lord, our grief can cover everything that we see and hear. Let your hope, your presence, and your healing sustain them. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, our world is a hurting place. Anywhere that there is hunger or abuse, hopelessness, homeless, violence, war, Lord, we know that you are there. You are working in often invisible ways to protect, provide, to heal, to encourage. We pray for our world. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for our missionaries, Didi and Serafina Panzo, servants in the Congo of Africa. Continue to keep your hand of healing upon both of them, especially Serafina, as she continues to recover from her stroke. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we pray for Anagret and Sadie, Electa, Linda, Haldi, Michael, Tom, Dave, Josh, and for those we mention silently in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Share God's peace with one another.
What have we to offer? What have we to share? The voice from the choir, hearts filled with prayer. God will not falter if we will dare.
The offering prayer is found both in your bulletin and on page 9 of your setting 4 booklet. Let us pray. Merciful Father, we offer with joy and thanksgiving what you have first given us, ourselves, our time, and our possessions, signs of your gracious love. Receive them for the sake of him who offered himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks.
We give thanks to you for the salvation you have prepared for us through Jesus Christ. Send now your Holy Spirit into our hearts, that we may receive our Lord with a living faith as he comes to us in his Holy Supper. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this, remembering me." After supper, he took the cup, He gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this, remembering me." We pray the Lord's Prayer as written in your book. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The body of Christ, broken for you. As you come to the Lord's table, this section. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. We give thanks to you, O God, that you have refreshed us through the healing power of this gift of life. We pray in your mercy you would strengthen us in faith toward you and in fervent love toward one another, for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Receive the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
God of joy and pain, God of sorrow, God of love.